welcome to our HIIT bootcamp. I'm just gonna give it a few minutes for everybody to come on the post. And again, welcome to Stay Fit with Joy. Today we have our HIIT bootcamp workout, and I'll just give it a few moments before we go over what we're gonna be doing today, just kind of allow everybody to start to come on in. And you will see some of the equipment that I have out today. So what I'm gonna be using for the workout today is a step, and I have a very small step, just something to elevate me. I like this one because it's very portable. But you can have any kind of step or anything that elevates you up that's solid and has a solid base, okay? I'm also gonna be using a kettlebell, okay? You by no means need to have a step or a kettlebell because you can do the workout without these pieces of equipment. But I did wanna incorporate them today for people who do have those pieces of equipment and would like to be able to use them. So I'm going to incorporate the step and I'm gonna incorporate the kettlebell today. But again, you do not need them. So some other options for you: just the floor for our cardio like we normally would do. The step is just gonna elevate us and actually give us a little bit more intensity if you have a step and you would like to do that. You may not even want to elevate your cardio intensity movements using the step. You may still wanna do them on the floor, so you'll see how you feel. We're also gonna use the step for some body weight moves, so when we come down to the floor, we're actually placing our hands on the step rather than on the floor, which elevates you a little bit and helps you get your legs underneath your body a little bit more. Okay, some of the options: not having that step or that kettlebell, you're just gonna have one dumbbell, somewhere like 8 to 10 pounds. If you have something a little bit heavier, you can still use those 5 pounds or less weights if you want to, but you're not gonna get as big of a workout in because you're only gonna use one weight for everything that we're doing today. So if you have a heavier weight, it's best you can use a dumbbell instead of that kettlebell. Now, you'll see that I have a chair close by. So if we're gonna have kind of a cardio move and then come down to the floor for a body weight move today, but if you don't wanna come all the way down to that floor, again, if you have that step, we're gonna elevate ourselves up with our hands on the step. But if you don't have that step, you'll be coming down onto the floor into a regular plank to do your plank movements. But if you are uncomfortable coming all the way down to the floor, you find it hard to do that body weight work on the ground, then I have a chair here to show you your options in using that chair for things such as like mountain climbers. You can elevate yourself up and it's going to keep you on your feet, so you don't have to go all the way to the floor, which is gonna make you stay upright a little bit more, and you won't have to have that complete up and down movement. So if you kind of get dizzy going down and coming up quickly, then the best thing to do is grab a chair and make sure you have that chair, because then you don't have to go all the way down to that floor and have that really quick up and down movement from the floor and back up, okay? So there are some of your options. Your step is gonna elevate your intensity today, if you have one. Kettlebell is just gonna give you a different way of moving with that weight. Dumbbell, totally fine. And a chair, if you'd like to elevate yourself up for that body work and not have to go all the way down to the floor and pop back up from that floor, okay? All right, so we're gonna get started warming it up and then I'll walk you through everything. So each circuit today, there's going to be 4 exercises, 2 using the step or the floor, and 2 using that kettlebell or dumbbell. I'm gonna do 4 sets of our first 2 using the step or floor, second 2 exercises using the kettlebell or dumbbell 4 times each, then we move to all new exercises. March it out right and left. Warming it up right here. Get those shoulders down and retract back. Engage that center. We want to make sure we get that body nice and warm. We got a lot of movement today. A lot that we got to accomplish. 8, 7, 6, 5, last 4, 3, 2, take it wide. Wide march. Eight more. 8, 4, 3, 2, march it back in. Last 8, 4, 3, 2, take it wide. Keep it here, let's go. 8 more wide. 8, 7, 4, 3, 2, march it back in for 4. Take it wide. March it in. 4. Take it wide. 4. Hold it wide and squat it. Bend the knees and bend the elbows. Push that bottom back. Get the weight to the heels and the feet, but keep those feet flat. We've got 4 more here. 3 more, and we slow it up. 2 more. Down to two, it's down and up. Three more times, down and up. Two more times, down for two and up. One more time, down. Pick up your speed for eight, seven, six, five. We've got four more here, four more. Three more, step back right and left and reach overhead. Right here, let's step it, reach and step. One right, one left, reach up as you step back. Step, tap it, or just step and bend through those movements if you can. Eight more times here, eight, seven, and we're back to a wide squat. Interlock those fingers behind that head or loosely behind the ear. Two more, one right, one left. Last one, take it right and interlock here or loosely here. Give way, open the chest, squeeze, and retract it out. Four more times. One more, press it up. Three more, two more. Release those hands, wide march, right and left. Four, three, two, march it in, narrow, eight. Four, three, two, take it wide. March it in, four. Let's take it wide, four. March it in, four. Take it wide and hold. Roll the shoulders back, take the hands on those thighs. Inch forward with a straight back and hold. Roll it up halfway and stretch that spine. Take that flat back down and roll it all the way up. Allow that head to come up last and roll the shoulders back. So there are no transitions in between our exercises. The first two I'm going to show you, four sets back to back. Then we have a little break and we'll do a kettlebell, okay? And I'll show you the two kettlebell exercises before we get there. Now your first two moves, if you're using the step, toe taps. So it's going to be the same whether you're using the step or on the floor. Using the step, toe taps look like this. If you're using the floor, toe taps look like this. Same move, except you're elevating your toes up onto that step. Second move, we are doing butt kicks. Right here, slow or fast. So see how I have my hands elevated on that step. If you don't have that step, you're on the floor here or here. Now if you don't want to come all the way to that ground, that's why I have this here for you. You can go slow, you can go fast, and elevate yourself up so you don't have as far of a way to go onto that floor, okay? All right, so let's get set for those toe taps. Once we're in it, toe taps and butt kicks in that plank position. Four sets. Get set and go. Right here, toe taps. So I'm gonna use that step. But remember, on the floor, same thing, right here. You're just not elevating onto a step to get those toes. 30 seconds for everything. Use those arms if you'd like to. You can also just keep those arms steady if you need. All right, so no rest time. Just transition down and butt kicks right here. Slow or fast, 30 seconds. Slow it down if you need to. Use that elevated position with that chair if you need to. Two cardio moves, unless you slow it down and make it a little more strength driven instead of intense. Right back up, toe taps. No rest, you're right back to it. So you're gonna really feel that intensity rise up here in those first two exercises and four sets. Bring it down here or here. If you need to lower that intensity, keeping it moving right here, totally fine. Or simply march in place at any point if you need to. Take it down and butt kick. Slow or fast. Or move through some intensity and some slower. Take it where you need to go. If you need it at any point, simply hold the plank, right? Get back strong if you can't move through it. Need to catch your breath a little bit, right? Right back up. Set number three. You're gonna already feel not intensity. That heart rate is already coming up. My body's already starting to sweat it out. Breathe through it again. Remember, you can bring it down. Nice and easy. Toe tap to the front on the floor. Up on your step. Bring your knees up. March in place if you need to. Let's bring it down. Up, kids. Slow. Fast. Or simply hold at any point as well. This is your set three. One more set of each to go. 30 second rest. While I show you the next two moves for this circuit. It up. Remember, no transition time. Just come up and right here. And if for some reason it's too much to do your planks, kick your bottom here. Give me some hamstring curls, okay, instead of the plank buckets. There's always something you can do, even if it's marching in place while you catch your breath. Bring it down. Let's get that final set of butt kicks in. Stay on your feet if you need to. Elevate it on that chair. Again, makes it easier. And you don't have to come down as low to that floor. Breathe. You're almost there. Coming on your final 10 seconds. Good, make your way up. Then give us a little pause on that timer. Get some water. Two kettlebell exercises. So you'll feel that intensity is up. Kettlebell or dumbbell. Reach for the inside of the foot. Circle around. Okay, second exercise right here for a row. Now if you have that weight, I have a 10 pound here. Reach for the inside of the foot. Circle around. This is your move here with the dumbbell. Hold it, move forward, and pull right into your belly. All right, we got four sets of each. Grab your kettlebell, or grab your big dumbbell. Get those legs wide, and start to reach for the inside of that foot, and circle around right here. Keep your legs straight on this one as you hinge forward. Circle and hinge. Circle and hinge. So you get a little catch of that breath here, but still moving, okay? Once again, we brought that intensity up super fast, right away. Right up into that intensity with those first two moves. Now you can slow it down a little if you need to, or you can keep it fast and intense. All right, remember, no transition time. Just grab that dumbbell, kettlebell, and inch forward, and pull it right up and into your gut. Good, not hitting your gut, but coming right up to it. Good, with that dumbbell or with that kettlebell. Good, bring yourself upright. Grab it. If you're holding that weight, you're holding it in that kind of downward position. Holding onto one of the big sides of that dumbbell as you circle and pass behind you. Set number two. Hinge forward and reach for the inside of that opposite foot. Get a nice stretch as you come down. Good, get your last one in. Come around to the front, grab that dumbbell or kettlebell, hinge forward, and pull it right into your belly. Good, bend and extend right here. Keep that chin off the chest. Kind of have this little hinge forward position with a nice little bend in the knees. Legs holding your position, nice and solid. As you move to that back. Good, come upright, grab that kettlebell or dumbbell, and back to your reaches and circles. Set number three, right here. got it. Nice and easy. Take your time. These don't have to be as intense as those first two moves. Come on up, bring it around. Pinch forward and pulse that belly. And one more set coming up. Coming on those last 10 seconds. Keep that strong position. Bring it up, grab that kettlebell, last time right here. Keep those legs straight, hinge forward and reach for the opposite foot. So again, you don't need to have that step or that kettlebell today, but I'm just showing you options if you have this equipment around, how you can use it, okay? For some of the things that we do, or for your own workouts. Just wanna kinda help you learn how you can incorporate this stuff that you might have around the house that you don't know what to do with. Right here, hinge forward, and it can help you elevate that workout. Challenge your muscles a little bit differently than maybe you will be used to. Kettlebell is just weighted a little bit differently. Feels a little different than a dumbbell. Sometimes a little more challenging for that body to use. And the step for some of that intensity work and that cardio work, it's gonna make you work harder by elevating you up and down on that step. But again, not necessary. Come on up. All right. So our next two moves, resetting that clock. We're starting with circuit number two. Okay, so we're going for two new step exercises. But again, if you don't have that step, you're using the floor. So basically, we're doing our high knee move for cardio. If you have that step, this is what a high knee looks like using that step. So you're driving those knees up and down as you come up and down that step. So we'll go with the right lead first set, left lead second set, if using that step coming up and down. Then we're gonna go for our mountain climbers. So then we come down, drive the knees in. So if you're using the floor, hands are there. You got that step, elevate yourself up. You'll be able to get a little more intense by elevating that body up. And if you don't wanna fully come to the ground, drive those knees in right here. All right, let's get set to do those high knees. In two and one, right here. So high knees on the floor, modification right here, okay? If you're using that step, you're coming up and down with that right. Driving it up. So this is gonna give you some movement and some elevation in those high knees by using that step. All right, take it down. Mountain climbs, they can be slow, they can be fast. So again, if you're elevated, you should be able to get a little bit more intense. If it's too much at any point, slow it down, or simply hold that plank right here. Get that strong first. Slow, or drive them in fast. All right, we're coming up, driving those knees up. Now if you're using that step, come up with the left. It's gonna give you a different feel. Gotta work that coordination. If you're a lefty, this side's gonna be a little bit harder coming up and down with. Just gonna feel a little more awkward. Good, take it down. Chair, step, or floor. Drive those knees under. Slow, or fast, or hold a plank. Stay right there, totally fine. You can start driving knees in, do it. Faster, here, 10 seconds. Back to your right knee if you're using that step. Up and down with that right. Driving those knees up. Now if you don't need that step, just give me those high knees on the floor. If the step begins to be too much, bring it to the ground, yeah? Take it down, right here. Slow, fast, or just hold the plank. Here, on the floor, or elevated on that chair. And use it when you can. Speed it up if you can. Coming on the last 5 seconds, one more set to go. High knees. Bring it up. Remember, if you're on the floor, drive it up. You're using that step. It's that left knee coming up now. Go, go, go. You're on that step. Work off the balls of the feet. Drive those knees up as you come up and down from that step. You got it, keep going. Breathe. Yeah, I feel it. Tense it up. If you need, march it on the floor. Catch your breath, okay? Last three. And one. Step four, or if you got that chair elevated here, drive those knees underneath. Okay, this will make your plank work easier. And you can even just hold your plank here. You can go slow. Okay, so if you have a hard time holding that plank and moving through your knees, being on the floor, elevated chair, or even a couch, is a great way to bring your body up and away from that floor, and then you can bring those knees underneath the body, fast or slow. A little bit easier. Awesome. All right, pausing that clock. Showing your next two kettlebell moves or dumbbell moves. I'll show you kettlebell first, okay? Right here. Dumbbell swings, holding onto that kettlebell right here. Just like this, okay? Then I'm gonna pop it up here, holding the base, and do some curls. Now, if you're using that dumbbell, you're gonna hold it like this and swing it through the legs, okay? And then right here for those curls. Same movement. All right, grab your kettlebell or grab your dumbbell. Get it in position. Get set and go. Dumbbell swings right here. So you want to hinge forward, swing that weight through the legs, and then fully rest up, lifting that weight to about the shoulders or slightly above. Good, nice work. Keep moving. Good. Grab the base or hold on to the weight with two hands right here. Bending, extending, working through those biceps. You're gonna feel that intensity, guys. All these moves have some sort of intensity to them. This curl, bringing that intensity down a little bit, but then we drive it right back up with that swing. So you don't have a lot of downtime here in those circuits, except for when you're previewing the next two moves. And in between your circuits. That's the only place you have a rest. Everywhere else, it's just back-to-back movement. No rest and transition time. Just all about constant movement right here. Good. Hold the base or hold each one sides of those weights. Still got two more steps to go. Good. Make sure you're breathing. There's that intensity, that heart rate. That body temperature, it's all up right now. This is your moment to try to catch your breath a little bit. It's the only place where you can actually do that, besides the little breaks that you have in between those supersets and those circuits, right here. Swing, set number three. Good, get that last one in. Get it in that base or the sides of that weight. And go for those curls. One more set of each coming up. And circuit two is done. We got 5 circuits today. So after this, we'll have 3 more left to go. Take one circuit at a time. Get yourself through that one. Good, last one. Take it down. And last and final set right here. Give me those swings. Good, get into position. Those curls, last and final set, you got it. Finish that circuit out, guys. You got this. Come on, hang in there. I feel it. All right, let's get some water. Cool it down a little bit. All right, we got our next two intense moves again. Resetting that clock. All right, so on the floor, you're doing your switch feet, okay? Just looks like this. We've done that plenty of times before. Tap back if you need. On the step, one foot comes on, and you switch it by elevating. So you gotta really kind of push your body up as you switch that foot, okay? You can step and switch instead of hopping, using that step as well, okay? And then, on that floor, right here, we're gonna bring the knee into the elbow. All right, so you're gonna either be elevated on the floor or on that chair. So you wanna open up the leg a little bit to bring that elbow to the knee. So it's not underneath the body, knee's on the side, okay? All right, get set, get ready. And go, switch those feet so you're in it. Right here, you're using that step. Propel yourself up so you can switch that foot. More step switch. On the floor, switching here. Tapping back if you need to. Good, bring it down. Now remember, to the elbow, you gotta open up. Try and bring your knee outside of that body as quickly as you can. Starting to open up those hips. Getting a little bit of that side crunch as you bring that knee outside of that arm. Bring it up, and you're right back to the switch. There are no breaks. Right to it. Remember, on the floor if you need, switch it out. Step is there, or using that step if you want to intensify it. You do not have to. Just gonna bring that endurance up, right? That cardio endurance right here. Bring that knee outside of that elbow, outside of that arm. Open up those hips with that little side crunch in. Look in the direction that that knee's coming in. Good, that's too much. Where are you? Right here, right? Totally fine. Hold that plank. Get that strong. Come on up. Switch it. I know, guys. I know. Not easy today. Bumping it up. Showing you how to bump it up. Just when you think you've mastered some of those moves, I'm going to show you how you can elevate them. Bring it down, let's go. Knee outside of that elbow. Look in the direction that that knee is coming in. Like a little side crunch. can't move anymore. I know it's hard. I'm not trying to say that it is. One more set if you can do it. Come on. March it in place if you need to. Right here, while I show you the next two moves. Come on, don't stop. Get that knee outside that elbow. Eight seconds. Come on, you got it. Three, two. I know. Come on up. Walk around, get your water. Watch me. I feel it, okay? I feel it. Watch me. All right, you either have your knee in pass, okay, with that kettlebell, or your lunge in pass, from the inside to the outside. Okay? And if you're using that weight, same thing. Just underneath the knee, or underneath that lunge, all right? And then, we got an overhead press. So you're gonna be right here, with the kettlebell, and with that dumbbell, right here, yeah? Okay, so remember, knee pass, or lunge pass, with your dumbbell or with your kettlebell, okay, whichever one you got. Get sets either come underneath the knee or step and alternate that lunge back. Let's go. All right, so we're a little slower than like our switching of our feet with those lunges, but it still is requiring a lot of energy, so we're gonna keep that intensity up here on this one. And then as we do that press overhead, we're also keeping the intensity up, because anything over the head is more intense already. Good, right here, kettlebell or dumbbell. I just can't come all the way up, right? Little push here, totally fine. All the way up if you can. So my kettlebell, just so you know, it's 12 pounds. So that's what I'm working with. Anywhere from 8 pounds to 12 is a good weight for this workout. But you can always lower it to 5 anytime you need to. All right, let's go. You're right back into that knee pass, or if you're opting for the stronger move, your lunge and pass. Get that knee up high enough to come underneath if you're doing knees. Get that lunge low enough to pass underneath those legs, if you're doing those lunges. All right, let's bring it center, and right here, press it. I don't know about you guys, but if you were ripping with sweat already, we're maybe a little more, actually probably about exactly halfway through, maybe a little bit more right now. Yeah, a little bit more. Set number 3, knees or lunges, let's go. Keep the rest of that body upright. You're not trying to lean forward, okay? You're trying to stay up and get the knee up high enough, or get the lunge down low enough to pass. Good, right here, and go. Gauge that center, make sure you're not thrusting the hips forward and arching that back. Keep those hips underneath your shoulders by engaging that center. Come on guys, you got it. Hang in there. One more set of these left. Let's go, knees or lunges. Good. Kettlebell or dumbbell, passing underneath those legs. Keep a nice, tall, and strong upper body. Keep working through it. I know it's hard, guys. This is not going to be an easy one today. Last exercise right here. We've got just two more circuits left. Remember, we only have five today because they are tough ones. And last one. Awesome. Get some water, breathe, and we're going to set up for our next circuit. All right, watch me on that step, okay? If you're using a step, you don't have to, okay? Basically, we're doing jump squats. So on the floor, your jump squat's here, or heels to toes, right? If you're going to use that step, we're jumping up onto the step, or stepping down. So we look like this, step down. Jump up, I want you to step down, not hop in, okay? And then, right here, on the floor, we're elevated up, plank squat thrust. That means you hop both legs in. Now, if your neck can't hop it, step both in and step it out. Or step it in and hop it out. Or hop it in and step it out. You can also elevate yourself. A lot easier to do those squat thrusts from there, okay? In that high elevated chair. All right, so jump squats. On that step if you're using it, or just your regular jump squats. 3, 2, and go. So remember, on the floor, jump squats. You guys all know how to do back heels to toes if you need. Right here, jumping onto that step and bringing it down. So you're using that step to elevate yourself. I like to step down instead of hopping, because most of the time, people don't hop down correctly. So I'd rather focus on the energy coming up and onto that step, which is more than just your jump squat on the floor, regardless, okay? Let's bring it down. We're elevated on that chair. I'm gonna hop and take it back with both feet. Or you can step it in and step it out with both feet. Bring those legs in, shoot those legs out. Bring it in, right back to those jump squats. On the floor, we're taking it all the way up and onto that step with that box jump right here. So you might see people jump on those high boxes at the gym. Same thing, my step, not as high as those box jumps, but same idea, right? Right here. Good, take it down. Elevated, or hands can be on the floor as well. So if my hand's on the floor, I'm just here. All right, I can hop it in a little bit. I can hop it in a lot. Depends. If you're elevated, it's easier to get those legs in closer. So same thing if you're up here. Easier to get in closer to that chair because your body's upright. Good. Back into those jump squats or those box jumps using those steps. Good. You guys keep there. Let me get some water. You guys keep moving because you'll have a break. You get your water in a little bit. You got these last two sets to take care of first, okay? Coming on those last 10 seconds. If you need that break, take it. If you need to just simply march it in place because you've come up way too high, and you need to bring it down, just march. Don't even go down. You can march in place right here until you catch your breath and you're ready to get back in to those squat thrusts or those jump squats. Beautiful girls all over the world. Good, bring it up last time, let's do this. Up, with that jump squat, heels to toes, or you're moving that jump squat now. So if you've been practicing those jump squats with me, here's your chance, if you have that step, to see if you can actually get airborne enough to bring it up and onto that step into your squat. You actually have somewhere to go with those jumps when you're using that step. So you have a goal of a height to get up and onto. All right, right here, step it in now, or hop it. Remember, you can be here, doesn't have to be that top. Here if you can. Elevated, on a chair if you need to. All right, pausing that timer, let's get our two kettlebell moves. Or dumbbell, right? Okay, I'm gonna come on over here. I'm gonna show you a few options here, okay? We're gonna grab from the floor, pull it up, lower it back to the floor, I'm staying squatted, and I'm taking it into the other hand. Now you can also do that with a dumbbell from the floor, okay? But now, if you can't come all the way to the floor, if you have that step, it gives you a great option to have a base that's higher, okay? Same thing with that chair, okay? You can squat, pull, bring it here, squat, pull, bring it on that step, okay? And all you need to do is give me a little upright row, okay? And you can also pass it here, by the way, instead of bringing it on anything. You don't have to come all the way to that floor, okay? And then our next exercise, tricep extension, okay? If you have that kettlebell, you're holding the base. If you have that dumbbell, you're holding each side right here, okay? All right, so elbow on that step, all right? Kettlebell, dumbbell, either on the step or on the floor, on the chair, it doesn't really work as well there. Okay, so you can kind of switch wherever you can instead of putting it on the floor, okay? All the way down if you can. Pull. And if you want to just do one side at a time, that's also an option. So you could be doing just the right this set, and then just the left, okay? Instead of alternating. So if you can't come all the way to the ground, a good option is to do just one side at a time, all right? Right here. So you have plenty of options now on that grab and pull. Tricep extensions here, use the back of those arms. Good, bring it down nice and easy first. Take it to the floor and switch hands at the bottom. Or you could be doing all the left right now instead of alternating if you can't come all the way to the floor. If you can come to that ground, you hold the squat and you switch every time. And again, it could be even just right here. And it could be here on one side, even. All right, let's go. Tricep extensions. Engage that center. Again, make sure you're not arching that back, right? You're not pushed forward through the hips. Good, bring it down first, then take an inch of your hand down to that floor. Switch and pull. Or you could be back in just that right hand if you're doing one side. Keep it close to the body as you come up and down. Good, I'm gonna grab it, bring it up, and right here, set three. One more set to go, and we got just one more circle left, guys. We're so close. Four more exercises coming up after we finish off these two. Good.
Down.
And switch. You got it. If your kettlebell's too heavy, hope you're doing this with your dumbbell. Mine's pretty heavy, but as long as I can go a little bit slower and maintain that form, I can stay here with it. Good, bring it up, right here, and behind that head. All right, you guys stay right here and finish it up. I'm gonna towel down all that sweat, and I'm gonna get ready to show you next few exercises. Awesome job, guys, hang in there. You're almost there. You got one more circuit left, but you need to finish up right here. 10 more seconds, guys, 10 more seconds right here. 8. Finish it. 3, 2, stop. Yes. All right, guys, you ready for our last circuit for today? Let's get it done, okay? All right, I'm gonna turn my stick this way where you can see me, okay? So you're gonna want it to be long ways, where you can put 1 foot on and 1 foot to the side. All right, this is our lateral move here, where I'm gonna propel myself up and over to the side. Now, if you're on the floor, okay, a couple of options here. You can do a squat and like a little hop side to side, or you can simply work your skaters for that lateral movement. Totally fine right there, okay? Then I'm gonna have you come down and do a plank jack. Okay, so you're gonna see me hold on to the sides of that step. Put your hands on the floor, or again, you've got that chair option, and do your plank jacks here. Tap it one at a time if you need to, okay? All right, so I'm gonna do 1 foot on, 1 foot off, skaters on the floor, or lateral jump squats, okay? Get set, and go, we're on it. We're on that clock, right here. So see how I push and propel myself up and over the center of that step. I get airborne as I come through that center. Now you can simply step it, make it a smaller move, but we want to make it a big one if we can. Good, hands on the floor, on a chair, or on that step, and plank jack it out. One at a time tapping if you need to slow it down. Here if you can. Continuing with some lateral movement in that plank position. At any point, if it's too much, hold the plank. Bring it in. Right back here, skaters on the floor, or lateral jump squats as well. Yeah, I can feel this, guys, in my heart and in my legs. Come on, last circuit, guys. Right? This is it. This is it. Let's go. Plank jacks. Elevate yourself on a couch or chair if you need to. Hold it right here if you need. Wider base of the legs, easier hold, it's gonna dig. Separate. Come on, we got this. Come on. I know. I'm suffering here too, guys, but we're gonna do it together. Any way you can. Still in good form and posture though, right? All right, plank jacks. One step through, guys. Let's do it. One more step coming up. Do as many as you can. Take a break if you need. Holding that plank. And then how many more can get in before you need another break? All Come on, let's do it. Time for you to find that inner athlete. Where is it? Come on, we're coming to that finish, guys. How are you finishing? I'm with you guys. Come on, I'm leading the pack. Just hang in there with me. Bring it down, let's go. Plank jacks. Let's go. Our last 15 seconds. I'm keeping it right here as best as I can. Trying to stay with it for the last 5 seconds. All right. Get that step to the side if you have it. Pausing that timer. Walk, march, water, yeah? Okay, with your kettlebell, watch me. We're gonna reach to one foot, up and over that ceiling. Then center, out and in. Now I'm gonna actually, 12 pounds, a little much for me on that one. I'm gonna take my 8. And here's your move with the dumbbell. Right here. All right, I wanna be successful, so I'm going for a 12 and dropping to an 8. All right, let's get set. Dumbbell or kettlebell. Right here, reach to that left foot, up and over that right shoulder. Good, keep yours moving slow. You want to take that intensity that you had, bring it down just a little bit. But we're still maintaining some intensity here. Good, we come through the center, push out towards me. Straight out, so up. Right through your belly out. And every time you push out with those arms, you pull that belly in the opposite direction. Okay, extend out and pull in. Right here, out and pull in. 10 seconds. All right, watch me. Reach that right foot, up and over that left shoulder. I feel like I'm running on fumes right now. I don't know about you. I'm gonna finish it, but it's all about working at a pace that I can manage right now, working on that last bit of fumes I have left here. Because I can tell you right now, that is where I'm running. Push out towards me. Good, what do we do with that belly as we extend out? We're pulling the belly in the opposite direction, right? All right, here we go, set 3. Back to that left, over the right shoulder. Center, push. We got one more set of each after this, guys. We are so close. Let that breath help you through. I know that's what's helping me get through it right now. All right, let's go. Last set right here. Down to the right, up and over that left shoulder. All I'm center. Here we go. Finish it right here. Extend out. Pull that belly in. We're right there. Last 20 seconds. What do you got left? Come on, a couple more right here. One more. Let's get that weight down. You guys are all done. Wow, guys, such good work right here. Let's march it out right left. Shoulders down, track back. Good, just shake it out a little right here. And relax, march. Good, we want to bring that intensity down. I don't know about you, but I am sweating dripping it with sweat right now. Heel across, little push. So I don't know if any of you have some steps out there, but it definitely elevated that workout. Again, you don't have to use it. So if it's too much for you, you just use your floor like normal. But at any point, if you want to elevate some of those moves, that is how you do it. Get that step out. Step touch right here. Little step. We're bringing it down. Don't want big moves. Last eight. Four, three, heel across. Press forward. Four, three, two. March it out. Right and left. March, roll those shoulders back, roll. Roll, two more times. March, deep breath in, inhale up. Exhale, one more time, inhale up. Legs out, wide and fold, hands on those thighs. And hinge forward, flat back, hold. Roll it up halfway, stretch that spine. Flat back down, roll it all the way up, allow the head to come up loud. Roll the shoulders back. Inhale. Exhale. Lower that left arm. Lift and reach. Let's get a little stretch in that side. And release. Take that arm across the chest. Press it in. Same arm up and back. Reach down and back. Press back. Bring it up. Lower down. Lift and reach the left. Bring it up. Take the arm across the chest. Press it in. Same arm up and back, reach down. Press back. Bring it up, lower down, interlock behind the back, open up that chest. And release, let's take that left foot forward, right foot back. You have that step, you can elevate one foot on. Press back right here. Step that back foot in closer, come up onto the back toe. Pelvic tilt forward right here. And release. If you can, grab. If you're not balanced, come off that step. Good. Bring it completely off. Take that right foot on or in front of your body and reach for those toes. And bring it up. Take that right foot on four. Step back to left. Press that heel to the ground. If you have that step, feel free to elevate up. Press the heel back here. Step that foot in closer to the front. Come up onto the ball of the foot. And pelvic tilt forward, stretching through that hip flexor right here. And if you can, grab that foot again. If you don't have that balance, make sure you come off of that step. Take it onto the floor, step off that foot, and left heel comes up, one in front of that body, reach towards those toes. Slide it up, bring it up, and take two deep breaths in. Exhale out and down, one more time in. Exhale out and down, you guys are all done. Fantastic work today, guys. Thank you so much for joining me. If you worked as hard as I did. I know you're sweating as much as I did as well. Awesome work today, guys. That was a tough workout. I did not make it easy for you. So thank you for joining me and fighting through this one. Just a couple of things and reminders. If you enjoyed this workout, make sure you save it, share it with others so that they can enjoy it. I will be uploading it to my YouTube hopefully by the end of the week, weekend or beginning of next week. I try to get them all in at least by the beginning of the week. And this Thursday, 7 o'clock strength training class is canceled for anybody who normally makes that. Okay, we'll resume strength next Thursday, but tomorrow we do have our 11 o'clock a.m. kickboxing and our normal Live with Joys all week as well. So the only difference this week is that the strength training is not happening. I have a conflict in my schedule for this week, but we'll resume it again next week, a normal schedule, okay? So everybody have a wonderful rest of your day and evening. Thank you so much for watching me. And tomorrow we have kickboxing coming, and we have our Live with Joys at 10 in the morning as well on the Mid-Island Y JCC, and also will be uploaded to my YouTube channel. Other than that, have a great night, and I will see you for the next class. Bye-bye.